What is your own personal philosophy of music? What effect do you want it to have on you, your audience?
Personal philosophy, my personal one is that's part of my life, you know, it's just a part of me, the music itself. The effect that I like to have for it on the audience is maybe in a hypnotic state, if not an awakening state, you know.
In 1969, I did an interview with Jimi Hendrix. His crew, Eric Barrett, Jerry Steckles, all of his crew told him this big educator from USC was going to come up and interview him. And this was at the Beverly Canyon Hotel. Comes out in nothing but a red silk kimono. But Jimmy kept on saying, I want to be heard, I want to be heard, I want people to hear what I have to say. And this was one of the best interviews he ever, so laid back. My name is Nancy Carter. I have a company called Rock Collection, where I collected rock and roll memorabilia. I have written a book. I've taken 10 years out of my life and literally lifted it. And it's the 10 most exciting years possible, 1964 to 1974. The now generation, the rise of the counterculture. And historically, I have it all in people's own words. These people were all my best friends, the biggest names in rock and roll. Jimi Hendrix, the Rolling Stones, Jim Morrison and the Doors. All of them, I was a groupie. I was the fly on the wall. I was given the opportunity to do a multi-image at USC for a master's degree, and because I had the ability, all original material, to get anybody I want. I ran around with everybody. I had the opportunity and the means. I was already a historian, but I had a premier rock and roll photographer at the time, Chuck Boyd, who photographed everything for me. And I audio taped everything. I have 4,200 feet of 16 millimeter color film. I have audio tapes to match. I have 35 millimeter slides, and I have me. I've got to do this now because I'm 81 years old. It's time that people see this. I've been wanting people to see this. In the event of my death, it all goes to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. It's in my will, all of it. But it will be buried. You know, I'd like to get it produced and out there now. I see the stuff on the TV, you know, all the documentaries on HBO and Showtime. I have that documentary.